In our previous video in the land governance series, we have covered various issues faced by landowners in our country. Issues like presumptive titling, land grabbing, and many other land scams are directly related to problems with the maintenance of land records. Land records are the data tracking the ownership and status of a particular piece of land maintained with the government officials. In India, it can be divided into two broad categories, textual and spatial. Textual records include the record of rights, which is the primary record that reflects the details about who has the rights over the piece of land. This is determined through the conveyance deeds and mutation orders. Spatial records refer to the cadastral maps that outline the geographic details sketched on the map. This map must be updated every time a new change is made on the record of rights. However, often this does not happen as both of these documents are maintained by different departments. The staff under the Tehsildar at the Revenue Department maintains the textual record, while the spatial ones are maintained by the Survey and Settlement Department. And the registration of the documents is done at the Registration and Stamp Revenue Department by the Sub-Registrar. These departments work in a standalone manner. This often leads to a lot of mismatch in the data across these departments, leading to difficulties in property registration, as it becomes very difficult for people to access this data. They would have to visit many departments to get hold of the appropriate documents. For the longest time, this data was recorded and maintained manually on paper and cloth. This led to years of land records accumulating on stacks of files, making it really difficult for people to verify their land details before purchase, leading to many frauds. To manage these issues and to make the whole process less cumbersome, the government has taken initiatives to bring land administration under the realm of e-governance. In 1985, the central government rolled out two schemes for strengthening the revenue administration, updation and computerization of land records. Later, in 2008, these schemes were consolidated under the National Land Records Modernization Program, later renamed as Digital India Land Records Modernization Program. This is a centrally sponsored scheme that sought to bring reforms in land administration in India. The ultimate goal of the scheme was to bring in conclusive titling for all land ownership. It wants to develop a modern, comprehensive, and transparent land records management system in the country. The components included digitization of textual and spatial land records and the integration of RORs with the cadastral maps, conducting surveys and resurveys of land using modern technology, computerizing the registration process, among many others. This scheme has been in action successfully for a little over a decade across the country. However, there are many issues with it as well. In their State of Land Report 2018, Center for Land Governance looked at some of the aspects of the digitization to track their progress. They noticed that while there has been significant achievement with respect to computerization of record of rights, its integration with cadastral maps is not up to the mark. The scheme has achieved a countrywide percentage of 86.35% for computerization of records, and around 54% of all sub-registrars' offices are computerized. While 46% of all cadastral maps are digitized, the rate of integration is only at 26.64%. This means that even though we have a higher rate of computerized RORs and maps, it is only truly effective if they are integrated together with the registration process. Integration of textual and spatial data enables real-time updation of records. For this to happen, the registration process must also be computerized fully. Updating the records in real-time, meaning as and when the transactions occur, is a great way to reduce property frauds. And digitization of records will only be truly successful when it leads to reduced conflicts and disputes. A major hurdle in the integration is the updation of cadastral maps. These maps are sketched based on the land survey conducted. In many states, the last survey was conducted during the British era, post which many states have also been divided. Some states like Gujarat and Maharashtra have begun the process of resurvey, but many are yet to catch up. This is due to the fact that land surveys are a very long and cumbersome process. It is also very resource intensive and requires a large staff to do. Even though states are supposed to conduct the survey every 30 to 40 years, they are still lagging. And until the resurveys are done and the cadastral maps are brought up to date, the integration may not always be correct. Recently, Andhra Pradesh government announced resurvey in the state owing to the many land-related issues faced in the region. The Survey and Settlement Director has urged the government to release a sum of Rs. 200 crores for starting off the project, and it is set to be conducted with the latest technology available. Digitization has brought advantages in the areas of computerization of records and ease of access to records. According to a framework built by the National Council of Applied Economic Research to track the ease of accessibility of the records to the people, they found that the major problems were the need of multiple attempts to access and download records, misspellings of names and addresses, language and translation issues, and other issues related to the interface. This shows that even though the records and circle rates are digitized, there is still a considerable amount of trouble faced while accessing these. While many states are benefiting off the digitization of registration process, it is important to note that they may not be operating to the full capacity. Out of the funds released by the center, as of 2018, only about 10.4% of it has been utilized. This could either be a lack of accurate reporting of how the funds are utilized, or could be because of a flaw in the design of the scheme. All of this points to the fact that while there are significant achievements in the field of digitizing land records, the ultimate achievement of conclusive titling is still a long way away. What are the steps that you think are needed to speed up this process and simplify the troubles of landowners in India? While better trained staff and newer technology are definitely a way out, do you think there are other ways to go about this? Is there a need for more accountability with respect to the funds? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below.